turn your back because he's going to jump on. And he's trying to keep one hand up here. There's other defense that we don't afford. If he gets enough pressure on us to bring us down to earth, don't stay there. At least don't let this hand go on the ground. It's alright to go with your hand if he's down low on your body. If he's up high on your body and you go on your hand, you're going to jar your elbow or your hand. So try to keep him down there. And as soon as he hits the ground, down back. Out of the area. Alright, so I know I was just playing the rules a little bit, but he's going to grab us one hand in here. There's better defense, of course, than letting it get this far. He puts our arse on the ground. Back up, up again. Trying to keep going, keep going. Even if it's down here, once he doesn't keep it down for 3 seconds, just keep going. Alright, so it's just more the idea of playing the rules. Give it a try on two, guys. One, two. Okay, guys, so being aware that that is a common tactic. And otherwise, quite often, like the person wants one of the simplest takedowns or simplest ones that a lot of people know is just putting his arse on the ground. Just running the point and putting him down. So when he feels that pressure, he quite often turns his hip over. You want to put his arse on the ground, so he turns his hip, his arse away from the ground. Harder to do. From there, we can start to climb up around him in quite a tight position. Or quite often, when we put, actually manage to get him down, say if we go down onto one knee, if I get enough pressure on to get him down onto one knee, he doesn't want his hip coming around to the ground and getting stuck there, so quite often he turns away from us to stand up. And that's when we're going to start to attack, right? So we're going to hit him off the ground. If he doesn't have that arm place, sometimes he can just jump through the arm anyway, depending on how strong he has it. But we'll just do it if he doesn't have good arm position, and we're going to go from there, right? So we just drop him down. As he starts going down, we're just going to dive straight in there. It's hard to do slow, just like spring over the top. Try not to crush your partner. Depends what way he goes. We'll just do it really slow. If he goes down to his knee and he's about to bounce back up, we can come in here, one hook. Choice is hook, seatbelt, hook and choke. Or if you go with this one, I'm leaning over, you hook the leg over the top and just lean. I won't do that one on Jamie. Just knee in here. Yeah, just knee in here and hook it onto the side here. This is a very common one. Straight into the choke. And you do it. So he manages to put me down, I'm belting up, and then I'm stuck. I'm scrambling to get up, I don't want to get up behind. My neck's open in that moment, where I'm just without you trying. I'm here, bang, jump. Alright, so that's what we're trying to do. It's just hard for me to dive on the leg properly because I'm too heavy. So just nice to slow down, bang.
Four.